So this is what they call the market. We're in Vientiane, which is the biggest city we've been in since Hanoi. Although it still feels different than Hanoi. Traffic's different. And this, I think they call this the market, but it's really more of a mall. They've got tons of stuff, kind of in sections. Here's the movie guy. Oh, there's the toy guy, I guess. Movie guy. Probably all illegal. Shoes and a whole lot more stuff that direction. Clothing. And clothing and shoes over this way. Jewelry. It's a big mall. I'm not going to walk through the whole thing. And this pink shoes for little girls. Looks like she's going to ride in them. And this elevator's broken, so we have to walk down it. This, I think, must be the jewelry floor. Jewelry. 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 More jewelry down that way. Jewelry. Yeah, it's definitely different than an American mall, where things are kind of scattered around and intertwined. Everything's grouped together here. More jewelry down that way. Jewelry. 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 And there's the top floor, middle floor, bottom floor. And it goes way down that way. What are we doing? Huh? Oh. I'm being directed to the escalator. Jewelry.
Waffles.
Jewelry. Jewelry. Looks like all the down escalators are not functioning. Smoothie guy. Lunch. Cameras. And where did the phone section go? This is the camera section. I actually got some good cameras. Nikon D7000, a lot of point and shoots, video cameras, Game Boys, watches. Clothing. Where were all the phones? Oh, they were down there. I want to get those. Phones. Watches. Shoes and bags. More cameras. Hello, somebody. More phones. Phones. Oh, there's a bank in the mall and a bunch of ATMs. Phones, 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 phones over there.
some of that.
Phones, more phones over there, is that by the phones, ooh, air conditioning, more phones. There must be like 20 different little phone booths or phone stands, maybe 30 through here. Gazillion phones. Anyway, it's a pretty big mall, at least for these parts. This guy's getting a little massage, maybe getting his, I don't know what all. This guy's trying to fix a, what is this machine? What is this? Is this reducing sugarcane? So this guy's been trying to fix this for a little bit. There's some kind of problem with the gearing or something, I don't know.
He for make the phone, it's fat, and make a ring.
Oh, it's for metalworking.
Yes.
Oh, okay. He flattens a piece of metal and then makes a ring from it.
Ah.
Okay, this is the jewelry section, apparently. Let's look. There's a monk. Oh, girl. Yeah. Oh, looks like electronics repair. Lots of old junk here. Looks like a plating operation. Plating the metal, making tourists think it's solid. Metal workers. Oh, they're doing some polishing back there. That guy initially formed those pieces on his machine back over there. Now he's doing a little handwork. And in the back there, they're doing some polishing over here. I'm not sure what they're doing over there. Counting money. Sorting things. And this guy. Thank you. texting someone on his phone. There's some jewelry for you. Rings, necklaces, bracelets, you name it. Rebar is used for everything around here. Rebar. Oh, some kind of tumbler to maybe to polish stuff.
Somebody.
Yeah, I think they do all their own plating around here. I'd be curious what the metal underneath is. Anyway, this is the jewelry operation. Outside. So yeah, that guy was just, looks like you can take metal and make a wire or a long thin piece out of it, which I guess you can eventually form into a ring or something like that. So, yeah, if you need something done, you can get it done here. And then Moon bought me some fruit, it looks like. All right, that's good enough for the tour of the mall. Oh, one more little thing. You're drooling, kid. Okay, bye-bye. Okay. Fruit. So this lady is making papaya salad fresh for Moon. Oops. I'm trying some papaya salad here. Mm. Very good. Mm. Your papaya salad is good. And this Coke is maybe the best Coke I've ever had in my life. Ice cold, and it's really hot here in Vientiane, Laos.
Now,
sticky rice, some meat, and it's gonna take like 3 days to get my visa for Thailand. All right, back to the Coke. This is a small tuk-tuk. That's it. I can probably fit about 6 people in here, maybe? You think? 6? 3 per side. Oh, plus 1. 1 hanging off the front there, 1 hanging off the front. 8. What do you think? 8? 8 passengers? 10?
Yeah.
Oh, 8? 8? Alright, yeah. No problem. Quite a bit of traffic here in Vientiane. Didn't make the light. Thank you. hotel is close by. Egg, and what else does it have in it? He put sugar on it, or is that
that's
like a
yet.
Cream that he puts on
milk,
it?
Milk cream, yes, like that.
And then what else?
Butter.
That's butter, then the big one.
Yes, butter.
What are those?
Vegetable oil.
Okay, well, they're different. They're two different ones.
This for egg, and it.
Oh, then he mixes the egg in that one.
Yeah.
Okay. He's got his fire in there. This one's for us?
Yes. They make fresh every time.
What's that?
They make fresh when you order.
They make it fresh.
Yes.
Take one bite out of the bag after he fixes it. He can put it in the bag and I'll have a bite. So far. He bought some birds in a cage. And then he's gonna let them go. There goes one. Two. Four. They're free. Moon is going to free some birds. They've got quite a few birds. Alright, Moon now owns these birds. What will she do?
Open.
Uh-oh. Oh.
Nope.
Here they all go. So the Mekong River's right over there. These guys are offloading this truck. You can see the bumper cars up on top there. These guys are offloading plates of steel. You guys are offloading plates of steel, which look pretty darn heavy. And they're coming down here and putting together the bumper car track. You guys are going that way. You got other guys coming this way. And the steel looks pretty heavy. They're working hard. Which is why they have a giant cooler, I guess, full of water and ice. And here's the steel floor for the bumper cars. And it's mostly done, which I'm sure they're happy for. Yeah, ice water, yeah. 'Cause these guys are working hard, really hard. Yeah, there's gonna be a big festival this weekend, boat races and festivities. And everyone's already having fun. There's already a lot of stuff going on here. Different rides. Kids playing here. And tons of street vendors selling food and other kinds, all kinds of other clothing and different things. Anywho, that's what's going on.
We're eating breakfast in the courtyard of the Malinam Phu Hotel in Vientiane, Laos.
Oh, Moon's clothes. They found them. We thought they were lost. Well, they kind of were lost for a couple days. Anyway, this is the courtyard. It's really nice. Our room's up there. This is where everyone eats breakfast. It's been a pretty good hotel. Yellow bamboo. We're at the really nice mall next to the pretty nice mall near our hotel in Vientiane. And this is the world's slowest escalator. Oh, it just sped up. There's a sensor. I was looking forward to shooting video of the world's slowest escalator, but so this is the line to pick up passports. It's a long line. It's a good thing we got here a little bit early. And then there. Probably 100 people or more.
Gotta get some gas in the tuk-tuk.
This is one of the bigger tuk-tuks, so it's got a regular stick shift and a bigger engine with a radiator, not just a motorcycle front end. Like that one is over there. That's just a motorcycle front end. This one, it's kind of a hybrid between motorcycle and a car. I don't know what is in his secret compartment there. That should get us back to the hotel at the end of the bus. Thank you.